Didn't you go out with Steve?
They went out that one weekend. Yeah. I haven't seen them for 2-3 weeks straight, legit. All jokes aside, right? Election day was
Tuesday.
He sends us a bracelet of him. Yo, I voted.
A bracelet.
Right under is, you see his feet, bathroom towel, and right under his wrist, all you see is his penis.
Jesus
Christ. So I saw God's penis.
That's the only thing I saw. God. That's the only thing you saw.
Welcome everybody to episode, go on,
15.
Quince.
Episode 15.
Like a quince, yeah.
Like a quince, that's a special one. Quince, yeah, that's a special one.
Podcast.
That might be.
Again.
Okay. Okay. I see you.
Oh, this is fire.
Yes. Yes.
This is fire. Oh my God.
Skinny dude bop over there.
Yeah.
I remember when I was there.
You got to really enjoy it. You're not going to get no more albums from this guy, so you better enjoy it now.
Like, yeah, that's why I rock that Pop Smoke album all the time.
I'm not telling you about no other rappers, dude.
All right, we'll get into it.
I'm really not.
You recording, Ralph, or no?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's been recording.
Oh, shit.
You know the vibe.
Damn, man, it's just like a numbing thing. I was every other month or something. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's crazy. Like,
So let's get the negative out the way, right? So we get that horrible news from King Von.
Rest in peace,
man. R.I.P. to King Von.
You kind of become desensitized.
100%.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's one of those things where it's just what can you do? Yeah.
Honestly, unfortunately, I thought he was bulletproof. So
it seemed that way.
I thought he would. Motherfuckers were scared of him. I feel like it was like, oh.
Guess he ran into a motherfucker who wasn't.
That's fucking crazy, man.
You know what's nuts, Wes? He got us on the music like 2-3 weeks ago.
Yeah, we just
when I was on. He was like, yo, he's like, this dude, King Von, his music is dope. I was like, all right, yo, I'll give it a listen. And I started listening. I was like, oh, shit, he got some bops. And then next thing you know, I see on Twitter, and he got shot. And I was like, yo, what the fuck?
I saw it this morning, to be honest.
Yeah. And then, like, what? Like, 2-3 hours later, I messaged you. He was like, yo, he ain't made it.
Yeah, because I was messaging him. I was like, I heard he got, I saw that he got shot, and I was like, damn, I hope he's all right. Mm-hmm. And then, like, 2 hours later, he messaged me, and then my brother texted me. He's like, yo, he's gone. I'm like, mm-hmm. Bro, get the fuck out.
So how I found out was through Steve. And not to make a joke and matter out of the situation, but he hit me. He goes, yo, he sends me the story. Like, yo, King Von gets shot at Atlanta. And he goes, yo, you for real the Grim Reaper of rappers.
Damn.
I'm like, what you mean? And he's like, yo, first it was Tentacion, because I fuck with Tentacion music heavy.
Mm.
He passed. Then I was messing with Juice WRLD. He passed.
I love Juice WRLD.
Then I started messing with Pop heavy. Everybody knows here. He when it came to Pop.
Big Pop.
Dude, my son texted me when Pop died. He's like, yo, you okay? So I was like, yo. So he told me about King Von and Favi song. I was like, you know what? I'm going to rock it. Playing it, all of a sudden, King Von told us, oh, shoot, it's me? Not to be the joke of man, but at this point, nobody's going to give me no.
You're wearing all black right now, so, you know.
In respects.
Okay.
In respects.
Okay.
I got to twist that up.
I actually changed my shirt because I spilled some pizza on the other one. So, it was a white one, but I spilled some pizza.
But RIP to King Von, man.
Yeah, RIP to King Von.
We'll do a little moment of silence real quick. Give him a few. No, not that refined. Shit, talking about bodies. Where the fuck is Gob and Steve at? Them motherfuckers been missing for a minute.
Man, I don't want to talk about that.
He's upset. He's really upset at God.
I'm feeling it, bro. Like, it's like we had the meeting the day before, no, 2 days before the podcast. And like,
he was active, too.
Steve, Matt, active in the meeting, scribing,
taking notes. He took minutes.
Giving examples.
Timestamps on the Zoom chat.
You know what
chat.
I mean? Like, all this stuff, right? You make me download this stupid app that I didn't want to download. This nigga's mad active in the app. Like, bro, like...
That's how you know Steve's mad Spanish.
Be like, yo.
He love WhatsApp.
Facts. All fucking Spanish. Yo, if you Spanish,
you got it, bro.
It's the only way you can talk to the bitch. Like, I know what's going on. She ain't got no iPhone.
No.
So she downloaded the app. You can turn your shit off. I get it.
She got the Android.
And then this dude, like, Dale, like, yo, y'all doing it at 7? Ooh, I don't know.
Something came up.
Oh, it came up today?
Uh-oh. All of a sudden, he got to go help his parents move.
Today? You knew it was moving.
In Steve's defense, he is aloof like me at times. Aloof. So we are forgetful. Aloof. I barely forgot you guys were coming until y'all started texting.
Our people don't say aloof.
You probably did. You're right.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Yeah.
I was at my girl house. Yo, babe, I gotta go.
Oh, man.
I got prior engagements.
I was handling business. I was out here trying to figure stuff out. That's don't make no
prior
sense.
Prior engagements.
Whatever,
man. I don't know. But since you mentioned that, we brought back Fifth Ward Media. We changed up the Fifth Ward production.
Don't make it sound so small. It's a full lane global, like, overtaking,
like,
change.
Bolts and holes.
Like, it's like an enterprise. Like, it turned from like one or two things that we were doing to like a umbrella, and then everything.
Talk on it, Ralph.
You know what I'm saying?
Give us your input.
It's a whole rebrand, a new relaunch. Yeah, we out here.
You know what happens when
we about to fuck shit up in 2021.
I rebrand like 3-4 times.
Ooh. Listen, this one rebrand, this better be it. No more rebranding.
Nah, no more rebranding.
Ralph sent me the calendar invite. Yeah. I was like, oh shit, I'm tired already. This better work.
The rebrand is like, for real.
No, this one's legit. You know this one we have what do we have? We have the Toxic Ass Friends podcast.
We got my blog. Things.
We got the Ralph Music blog.
We got a new podcast coming out.
Which we will announce next week.
Just cut me off.
It's called marketing, bitch. It's called marketing, bitch.
I think another new rebrand is coming
soon.
Good
facts. We have another rebrand.
We're about to have both creative differences.
Yeah, check.
Nothing gets announced until next week, buddy.
I'm about to unaccept this motherfucker.
Well, I only had you announce my shit because I knew I had 25 of them motherfucking shirts in the delivery. I'm not going to say nothing about it.
Shout out to DemiGod.
Until it's already there, but... Yeah, no, it's a lot of stuff, a lot of moving parts. My wife looked at me like, why y'all having an iPad Zoom meeting? Like, what is this? I was like, nah, babe, this is serious. She's
real.
Like, well, what have you been doing for 13 weeks? Like,
oh, shit. Oh,
shit. Wow. No, wait.
Like, you get up and you go record this podcast. I've never seen you have a meeting about what you're going
to
do.
Because we have to structure things.
I think people are structuring things a little more now.
Exactly.
I don't know.
Wes, because the most organized person came back into the fold.
I'm not
That's
gonna,
why.
I'm not
right here, the guy who's holding the phone off.
Right now, I just want to get a tax break. Like, if we just LLC this shit, and, like, what? Like, I get a tax break on shit. That's the only reason
Ray
I'm going
to
do
this. When Ray into the podcast, he gave me no kind of regulation. No, sorry. I can do whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It was wild.
So, therefore, not one episode was introduced, because I didn't give a shit. So, therefore,
never.
It didn't matter. And I was like, eh, whatever. And he was just, he's cool with it. So, I'm like, oh, well, if he's cool with it, then I guess that's how I'm rocking.
Did we introduce this one?
Yes, I did.
Okay, cool.
Because now you're like, you're
like, that's exactly how
Yeah, literally. He's like, man, he's like mad small.
My Napoleon, whatever the way for complex.
Like, why is he stopping his feet? So low, center of gravity.
He's looking down like, he's so cute.
Yeah, he's like,
he got so fast.
Really, he's like,
barely 5'7", Jesus.
He's like, maybe sometimes we can, like, introduce that.
Just once in a while.
Okay, whatever, man, that's fine.
Some structure.
He didn't do that until fucking Ralph showed up.
It was like episode 15.
It was literally Ralph's episode. We were like, yo, we should probably introduce it. I'm like,
who the fuck are you?
What? Introducing? Well, this is the problem too. With Steve not here. We usually introduce the podcast making fun of Steve.
Have we made fun of Steve lately?
No, because he ain't never fucking here.
All right, so let's segue into making fun of Steve real quick.
I can't make fun of him because he's not here, because I want to know what he was doing, because then I can make fun of everything that he was doing, and I can forego my theories that probably aren't true at all, but I can put them on him.
So how about this? Let's make fun of him how he was so avid on getting women listeners on that production meeting we had yesterday. Because he looked like he was sweating.
He was upset.
He was like, yo, like he was like, so we were Y'all want me to call somebody?
No. Like... he put his head down.
Steve got the hose.
He put his head down. He's like, yo, we really got it.
Yo, he must have the hose if he was that adamant about
it. Listeners, man.
We need some.
Because Steve's been hoeing this whole time. That's why he's not here.
I think so. Yeah.
There's no other.
I don't think he's helping his parents pack.
He's not. He's packing something else.
He's packing. He's unloading.
That fits no more.
It's so much easier when he's right here, because then I can just feel his vibe, and I'm like, oh, you got some ass last night.
Yeah, he definitely got ass on that. Chris's episode.
Oh, he came in like he was like a different person. He came in with Superman.
He had a glow.
I had no idea who he was at all, whatsoever.
He was like, I'll handle it. Like, who's this guy? Where'd you come from?
That's the thing. You come in there with like that newfound confidence.
Yeah, he strolled in.
Because you don't put in work, so
strolled in kind of late, but not too late.
Not too late.
Like, oh, they just turned the lights on. I can sit down now.
Mm-hmm.
With the ice.
He was Iverson practice. You talking about practice? Yeah, I'm surprised he even got on the Zoom chat. I think he was just bored.
He was definitely bored.
There was no way.
He made it seem like he was like, I don't know if I'm going to be home from work.
He brought pen and paper and everything.
Yeah, he had it all. Like, I was sitting in my wife's office and I was not prepared.
I'm still waiting for him.
You're in her office.
No, I'm in the office.
And you're still like.
Not prepared. I had a glass of wine. That's the only thing I had.
I'm still waiting for him to send me the picture. I told him, yo, send me a picture, whatever you wrote. I'm still waiting on that.
You're not getting the picture. He just did that shit for optics, because he knew he was about to dip out because he had a date planned.
He just started writing out Steve a whole bunch of times.
Oh, he had to be writing like a whole bunch of stuff. I'm just writing Steve.
Steve.
He brought you up, Ray. He sent me a screenshot of what he wrote down.
Did he really?
Yeah, I have it on my phone.
Ah, shit. Damn, it would have been much better if you
didn't. I didn't want to share.
Where?
Fuck that shit.
Y'all got me in WhatsApp going off. My wife's like, oh, what's that?
Oh shit, bro!
I'm like, bro, I've never had WhatsApp. I told them I didn't want to download it in the first place, now my shit.
So the reason we made him download is because we got two people who don't have iPhones.
Yeah,
Paul and Steve don't have iPhones.
It's hard to.
So we can't do iMessage.
I respect it.
I respect it too because it makes.
Gross.
I don't have iPhones.
And it makes sense, right?
It does.
But it don't make sense when my shit's going off every 5 minutes.
That's why, real quick. So
and WhatsApp.
The ongoing joke is that I have everybody on Do Not Disturb.
And this is fact.
Everybody. Today was the first time my girl was like, what's wrong with your phone? I said, that's the fifth word media.
This is the first time?
You're not allowed to put that on Do Not Disturb.
You can't put it on
and
Do
she's,
Not Disturb.
And she's like, hey, you didn't put it on Do Not Disturb? I was like, no.
She does. So I don't know. She looked at you like, gross.
So I got a feeling like my phone's going to get ran through a couple times.
I mean.
I guess it's hot.
Exactly. You good?
Sometimes I dropped
you Gucci though.
They gotta keep you honest sometimes.
Shit, I'm on too.
And you ain't out here flexing.
No, not at all.
You know what I mean?
Actually, I got a little bit of love with I'm trying to get rid of because I bought a DemiGod apparel shirt. Had to order a large because the medium was a little too snug.
Mm.
The medium was not.
Shout out to
the medium fits.
Demi,
it's not. We're not in high school no more. We just had this conversation.
This is true. Was that a good segue or no?
No,
that was a good segue.
I mean, you can segue into it. Yeah, it's something, you know. Man. It's just you can hold the
shirts.
Hold the attire.
What is it?
Creative. By myself.
We do a little everything out here. Well, Koel does a little bit of everything out here. I'm just here for the show.
Created by myself. Printed by me.
Look at that. It's even too.
Printed myself, this is good quality, this is a little soft, for your other apparel companies, you see how it's aligned from the back
because y'all be tripping, it should be all over here, y'all be making it a little weird.
I got rulers and crafts and scissors and all kinds of stuff. I don't know what I'm doing. I picked that up. I literally picked this up in a week or two. I had no idea what I was doing. I've never done it.
And if this is what you came up with is a week or two, just imagine, ladies and gentlemen. Just imagine.
That's what I'm saying. If I would have put some time into it. I have like a, I told them this like in one of like the early episodes, I think. I have like a, I read a lot, but like I have like a mythology obsession. So like anything mythology, I know.
So DemiGod, I got you.
And I have like a bona fide obsession.
Real quick, I just want to make fun of everybody who skipped the geometry class.
Geometry class?
Ain't that the one with the rulers and all that, or no?
It could be. It's just a math class, but
I'm a dirty. So DemiGod, where did DemiGod come from? So you have
DemiGod
an obsession?
DemiGod came from, like I said, so it came from just a obsession with mythology in general. And demigods are half gods, half humans.
That's fine.
Because the gods like to come down and, you know.
Oh, so I see. Think, I see the concept I mean? Now.
He's like Hercules, yeah, yeah. Right?
So if you research it, the most toxic nigga on Earth was Zeus, because most of the demigods are his kids. And he was just getting it in.
What about Zeus? Achilles? Was Achilles his demigod?
Achilles was...
Who's his daddy? Well. Who's Zeus. Him too?
Yeah, nigga.
Holy shit.
He was getting it in. You know what I'm saying? But then there's descendants of demigods and so on and so forth. Ah. Got Alexander the Great right here, descendant.
Didn't he like butt sex?
Hercules on the top, you know what I mean?
Didn't Alexander the Great do gay stuff?
Bro, don't tell me anything.
It was in the movie.
Don't tell me anything. What are you talking about?
I'm just asking.
My last name's Alexander, bro. Don't do that.
I'm just asking. I don't know these things.
Don't do that.
I mean, back then for entertainment, when they did theater, the men played the man and the woman. Because women weren't allowed to
was
be on stage.
Was there porn back in the day like that?
They didn't do porn. They just did wild orgies.
Yeah. Like theater
porn?
They just had orgies.
There was no need for the theater because you could just come to the party.
Damn, what was that show on Stars?
Come to the party and come at the party.
Spartacus.
Spartacus
was wild.
Spartacus
was
litty.
Crazy.
Spartacus made me wish I lived in that time.
Crazy, man.
I need to live in that time. I feel like I'd be much better off living in that time.
Really?
Hell yeah.
I think they did a good job with the main, you know, the main character passed away.
Yeah, yeah.
I think they did a good job finding a replacement.
Yeah, when they spun off on it, yeah. I love that show. I rewatch it all the time. I love it. Really? It's great, yeah. I love that show. But
that's a little gory.
That's where it came from. So it came from just me thinking I'm better than everyone else, which is not true, but I can think that.
It don't matter.
That's fine.
As long as you perceive that.
It's something that I was really interested in. I got with a company to help me design the logo. Just based on what I was actually looking for, paid for it, copyright, done deal. Then I just started doing all the research that you need to do to print and cut and measure and stuff like that to make your own shit.
Is that time consuming?
Very. If you ask my wife, I sat on my laptop for hours.
Yeah?
Mm.
Hours at a time.
Like, is it to line up the shirt or is it like...
Once you figure out how to do it, it's not hard then because you're doing the same... You realize you're doing the same size multiple times. Mm. So you just need a template for your mediums, you need a template for your large, you need a template for your extra large and things like that.
Too much stuff.
You still gotta go... Look, I had the templates, but it took me hours to make the templates. So you know what I mean? So you still gotta go and do the research. You still need to research all the tools you need because I was getting them one by one because... I was trying to print something, and I realized, like, okay, this would be much easier if I had this tool.
Mm, gotcha.
You know what I mean? So I was like a lot of growing pains. I only messed up 4 shirts out of, like, 60.
Well, that's not bad.
You know what I mean? Like, crooked or, like, I didn't heat it enough
or
something like that. Like, so...
Oh, shit, I didn't even think of that part.
Yeah, because you got to heat, you got to get a press, you got to heat the press, you got to make sure...
So you purchase all that, you got to press it.
Yeah.
All that stuff.
I bought the press. It's not big, so you can buy it and you can just put it in the house. I do it right in the house. It's real simple. And then you gotta figure out. The hardest part was figuring out material.
I'm not gonna lie, this shit feels amazing on my skin.
That's what I mean. So when you figure out material, that's when you figure out your price point.
Mm.
Because if you're paying mad money for the shirt and you sell it for so much, you need to make a profit.
Exactly.
Right? So I had to test at least like 4 or 5 different styles of shirts before. The first style I had, the neck was too tight. It was soft, but the neck was too tight.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, I can't rock these because I don't, you know, things can't be.
I ain't gonna lie, because I was gonna order a medium, but then he told me he posted a picture that should be a medium. I said,
he was like, yo, that's a little snug on you,
like,
buddy.
I'm looking at Koel's biceps like, wait a minute. This motherfucker's been working out.
But no, so that was it. I got new styles coming, not just the classic one, like this one. This one's a newer one. I ain't released this yet.
Ooh, sneak peek.
I'm putting demigod names on the front in Greek letters.
That's fine, because I had no idea what it was.
I'm still trying to figure
it out. You'll never know what it is unless you go on the website to order it. So when you go on the website to order it, you know what you bought with the description of the demigod that you are purchasing.
That is strategic marketing right there.
How many different types of demigod? Is a lot?
There's at least, from just a little bit of research that I did real quick, there's at least 30. But depending on
busy, bro.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Zeus was busy, bro. And there's like 30 of them, and like half of them are Zeus's kids. So
is Percy Jackson really one of them? Or?
Percy Jackson is the son of Poseidon, but he's a fictional character. There is a son of Poseidon named Perseus, which I have a shirt.
Mind it.
Before thinking about making shirts,
yeah.
You ask my girl, like, any movie that comes on, if it has any kind of mythology on it,
you on it.
You're watching it.
I'm watching it. So it doesn't matter. I'll watch it, even if it's bad.
And now you probably critique it. Like, that's not true.
Yeah, it's not true at all.
Since we're on the topic, what is your favorite mythological movie? Like, dialect, action. Like, my favorite, and this is me being biased, is Brad Pitt. Troy. That Troy's dialect.
Great. Troy's great.
Dang, see that.
Troy's good, but Troy steers away from, Troy's so far removed from the actual mythology story. World.
Yeah, of course.
That, like, yes, it makes sense and it fits there, but it's more after, like, people stop believing in the gods and stop showing signs in the gods after that.
See, I didn't get
so
that.
I'm earlier in the point where, like, the gods are still showing people signs because they're still active and around. So, like, at that point, by the time you get to, like, the Troy era and the Trojan War and all that stuff area, people have stopped praying to the gods at that point, so they're not as active as they were before because they're not receiving as much worship.
So it's a different timeline.
It's definitely, it's 100% a different timeline. It's separated from it. My favorite one, now at this point, I guess, would have to be Clash of the Titans.
The original.
Wrath of the Titans.
The original Clash of Titans.
Not the original one.
You know what I'm talking about.
I did watch the original one.
Because I remember when I was young, I remember watching that.
Yeah. My brain hurts when I watch it because it just looks so bad.
But back then.
Yeah, exactly.
You probably was like,
back
oh,
then,
oh,
that was my. But now I watched, you look but at I watched it. It anyway just because I wanted to know, you know, what it looked like. But Hercules is my favorite Disney movie, so.
Those Hercules movies was lit, though.
But none of that shit.
What about the series? None of that Hercules series with.
I remember that one, too, yeah.
Kevin Serbo.
Kevin Serbo.
I used to watch that shit.
And then the spinoff with Xena. Were you Princess?
What was that sound she made?
I can't do it.
And then she had all the bitches with her.
Oh, hell yeah.
She had all the bitches.
She was gay, right?
I think so.
Lucy Lawless. She was in Spartacus, too.
Yeah, she was buying the show.
Yeah.
In Xena?
Men and women.
She was fire as Spartacus, too. I thought she was mad sexy, I'm just saying.
Yeah, but that's because you have, like, that childhood memory.
That's true.
That's true. Childhood memory.
I still look at Xena.
I already know.
I told my wife just the other day. I was like, I know the first two white women that I fell in love with when I was younger. It's Alyssa Milano.
Yes.
Charmed. And,
Nah, you ain't fuck with Topanga?
Nah, I wasn't even
big ass titties when she was 14.
Nah, I was still
it was that new season when she came.
I was still going to school in Hillside at that time. So it was.
But he's younger than us.
There's black girls everywhere. I was like, whatever.
Cool. Not for nothing though.
But once I saw Alyssa Milano for the first time, I saw the Mummy, the chick from the Mummy.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
Rachel Weisz.
Yes.
From the Mummy and Constantine. She's in Constantine.
Yes.
I haven't seen Constantine.
That was when I was like, you know what? I think that's for me.
He said, I think that's for me. He's like, it's the bunnies for me.
He knew it too.
I went on to date more black girls after that.
Is this stereotype real though? Like, black guys love white women?
No, it's not real. It's people like different people.
You sure, man?
I'm pretty sure.
Is your part of that stereotype?
I've slept with black women before. I've dated black women before. I've dated Spanish girls before.
All right, hold on. So we have another stereotype here. I ain't gonna point no elbows or nothing like that. But Wes has a Spanish woman, right?
From hey,
yeah.
But that's fire, though.
That's fire. Yeah,
that's fine.
But that's regular, though.
Is it regular? Well, black guy and a Spanish girl? That's super regular.
You know what?
And think about it, he Caribbean anyway, so
that's true.
Is it really so that different?
They make fucking tostones,
no, but y'all share a fucking island.
We share an island, bro.
He's Caribbean.
We're not gonna get into those politics.
I'm just saying, but what I mean is really
you're gonna split the audience. You gotta relax.
Nah, but what I mean is like, is it really that much of a difference?
Huh?
It ain't that much of a difference. You know what I'm saying?
Don't do that.
It's tough because you know. No, there's a lot of similarities. Let's say that. There's a lot of similarities.
But
I ain't gonna lie.
But in the United States, they don't see that.
No, they see black guy, Spanish girl.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But if you tell me, because when I tell people I'm Haitian, they're like.
But you're like more Americanized than anything. Like, I'm Dominican, but I'm more Americanized than anything. I'm not super Dominican.
No, I mean, I'm not.
No, you're not.
I mean, you're kind of Dominican.
I didn't wear my bracelet today just because I knew Wes was going to come.
I mean, you do have a secret family.
Jesus Christ.
Listen, I'm talking about them. I haven't checked on them this whole year.
Damn, you're bad.
Like a true Dominican. That's painting a lot of narratives right now.
We're not painting any narrative. The narrative has been painted.
You painted that narrative
I'm saying,
since painted, 2019.
You painted the shit out of that shit.
Listen, I've been potting since
2004.
You see what I'm saying?
2004.
You see what I'm saying?
I got my baby mom's pregnant toward the end of 2004. Had a kid at 2006.
He's not Dominican.
Hold on.
I never pull up.
That's impossible that you got your baby mom pregnant in 2004 and then
no,
you had your kid in 2006?
2005.
I'm like, damn, how long was she pregnant for?
Pregnant for
like 24 months.
She was waiting for the right time.
So yeah, we spoke about this on another podcast too. But I 2005, 2006, we had a kid. And then
you went to capitalize on your Dominican ways and things changed.
Oh yeah, then we broke up.
Yeah, no,
and then the last 7 years have been insane to say the least. Mm.
You okay, man?
Single life is crazy. Yo.
I don't even know what that is.
Man. I also would not.
It's,
even
it's scary. It's scary.
It's probably super gross.
Yeah.
Wait. It's probably it's so what? Nasty.
It's disgusting. I'm telling you right now.
All right. So.
It's so disgusting.
So single life in your early 30s
is exhausting.
And then if you like date somebody who's in their mid 20s, that shit's exhausting.
Well, you have nothing to talk.
Exhausting.
Oh no, there's stuff to talk.
No. If it was early 20s, they would have nothing to talk about. But mid to late 20s,
I only deal with women that have kids.
Well, that makes sense.
Like, if you don't have kids, then
you'll never understand.
I mean, that and they take birth control, so I'm Gucci. You know what I'm saying? Like,
wow. Okay. I thought you were thinking from the path of.
Do you, like, hand like a slip?
She
like,
has a kid. This is your so maybe she understands.
He's Dominican, bro. He doesn't think about that.
This is your qualifications. Yeah. You know, like, this is your, if we're going to commit to this, we need.
Oh, you had an oops baby? Okay.
How many oops babies do you have?
It's me, too.
Sick out here.
Like, I had one in high school.
Shut up! Me too!
we have that one common
denominator.
We have kids. You know what I'm saying? Like, they understand.
Because
I dated somebody who didn't have kids and they weren't understanding.
Well, they'll never understand.
No, they won't.
Because I know myself. I wouldn't understand. I don't give a shit. You have kids? What the fuck does that mean to me?
So for somebody who doesn't have a kid, Ralph, we'll give you this question as well. If you're dating somebody... Obviously, you're married, so but if you were in the dating world and the girl you're talking to goes, you call her twice back to back, boom, yeah. Boom, she don't pick up, right? But you, mind you, you told her, yo, I'm about to scoop you up, we about to go have dinner. She don't pick up. You're like, that's fucked up. She call you, she texts you, she don't call you back.
Bro, you've unlocked my
open Pandora's box.
My immediate pet peeve.
So she texts you, yo, my bad, my baby daddy's here. I'm going to hit you in like 10, 15 minutes when he leaves.
See, I don't even know.
Wait, hold on. Wait.
What you mean?
Can I add some parameters around this?
Damn, nah, you can't.
Yeah.
Yo.
That's a baby
But
daddy.
Don't fucking tell me to...
Yo, but real quick.
How far away are
you? Are we in a full-blown relationship? Yeah. Or are we just like, getting to know each other?
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Or are we just fuck buddies?
Yeah, you gotta have
to. No, not fuck buddies.
Right. Is it like a legit relationship?
Because if you're fuck buddies and your baby daddy's there, I'm like, all right,
dude.
No, no,
you catch like her. I catch you on the flip side.
You like her. You like her. You take her now.
So you've been taking her? Or is this the first?
No.
So you've been taking her out?
Yeah.
Okay, so you've been taking her out. She know how you get down when you say you about to take her out, which is important because women need to know what kind of man you are when it comes to that, because you set a parameter, pretty much, not a parameter, like it's a thing, but a woman knows, like, he does this, I know he gonna do this, I know he gonna do this, right? So, you're telling me that I tell her...
You dress too, nigga.
Bro, you dress. Come on, bro. You're unlocking all my pet peeves.
You dress and you just went like this.
So it's 7:15, right?
A good cologne, dude.
So it's 7:15, right? Good cologne. I live 30 minutes away.
That's 20.
I live 20 minutes
20 away. 20 makes a big difference, by the way.
It does. So I live 20 minutes away. It's 7:15. I'm like, yo, I'm coming to scoop you up. 7:15.
And the restaurant's by your house.
And she's like, I bet. Cool. I'm like, boom, get on the road. I'm like 5 minutes away. And then she's like, oh, my baby daddy's here. You got to wait. No. Tell him you're going out. He either taking the little nigga or you're not. Okay? Because guess what? I'll take him with us. I'll pay this little ass too. Okay. But you not about to have me sitting in a car like a fucking douchebag sitting out here waiting for you.
So that's a red flag. Like, nope, I'm done.
It's not a red flag. It's just, it's inconsiderate.
Yeah. No, I agree with you on
some
that
some of
part.
Those conversations last longer than others, though.
I don't give a
depending
shit.
Depending on what's going on with the kids, too.
I don't care.
What if it's an emergency?
That's different.
But you're reasonable.
Yes, but don't say, yo, he's here. Wait till he leaves. Say, like, yo, something's up. Kid's sick.
Some women don't communicate.
Like, well, that's her. That's her.
You're inconsiderate.
That's the problem. You're inconsiderate.
If something like that happened to me and I have the kid.
Because she's hiding him from the world, not hiding the world from him.
And I'm like, yo, she just popped up. She's not going to believe that for a second. She's like, why would she just pop up? You obviously spoke to her. So what the fuck?
Yeah.
So let me play devil's advocate then.
Don't ever, because you can't.
Thank you.
She's wrong.
No, we're wrong. I'm with Koel on this.
Bullshit.
All right, so I got Koel's answer. I'll play devil's advocate Wesley in 2 seconds. Ralph, what's your answer?
I mean, I'm with him on it.
It's bullshit.
You're not having it.
No.
Nah.
You staying away from him.
That motherfucker.
You gonna hit it that night?
We drive into the ER because he's sick. Yes, we all taking him together.
I like that energy. A little blended relationship going on.
If she's telling you wait outside or she's telling you stay home or whatever, it's like
you better knock on that door. Like,
wait,
yo,
and I met the kid too? Like, cause I've been dating her, right? Have I met him yet?
But that says something. Yo,
I haven't met the kid yet.
But Ray, but then that says something about her because then that means she's not telling her baby dad that she's seeing somebody.
No, you don't know that. Or what if her baby dad is just crazy?
Scrap up, nigga.
For real. Square up.
I'm not saying
square the fuck up.
But maybe he wanted them dudes. You know what I'm saying? Like, he just
wanted them dudes, too.
We got Alex. I had a brain on his arm. He over here.
I'm one of them dudes.
He's a demigod. You better stop it.
I'll tell
you
right now. Relax.
My 401k don't cover none of that.
He said my 401k.
I don't either. But what you're not about to do is make me drop 20 minutes and make me sit outside.
Yeah, if she knew that, you know, you had this prior engagement, like, all right, I'm picking you up at this time, and she texts back, okay, yeah, I'm going to be ready, da-da-da-da-da-da. And then when she's outside, oh, baby daddy's here. Nah. Then he could probably text back.
There's more behind.
Leave him in the house.
Is everything all right?
You know what? Leave him in.
Is everything good? Oh, is he babysitting?
Yeah.
Well, not babysitting. Is he watching his kid?
Is he babysitting his son? Hold on, real quick. Is he babysitting my kid? That's his kid. No, you can't. You can't babysitting your kid, bro. That's his son. You spending time with him. That's quality time with your son, bro.
Come on.
That's not babysitting.
Bro, you call it babysitting?
My son is 14.
That's quality time. What?
He don't want nothing to do with me.
Facts. He don't even want to hang out with me.
Look, let me tell you something.
Because he don't fuck with you.
At 14,
did you fuck with your father at
14? At 14, he might be.
Exactly. But my goal, my son's only 5. He just turned 5. My goal is to make sure that me and my son, we have that tight connection that I didn't have with my dad. I love my dad to death. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know he did what he had to do, you know, to make things better for me.
How many times have he hugged you in the last year?
I was telling them. We're unpacking you. Yo, this is a trigger point for him.
Come on.
Yo, he ain't been hugged by his dad in a long time. So he has a lot of unpacking to do.
Ain't he like here?
No.
Yo, go ask your dad for a hug.
Yo, go tell him to hug you.
Right here, right now, bro.
No, we won't right past.
We won't
right past each other.
Hey, bro, go ask your dad for a hug, man.
We won't right past
you each other.
But wait, you talk about it so much because you want that hug.
I do.
Yeah.
But I want him to want to give it to me.
Yes. Yes.
That is sick.
You are sick, nigga. I told y'all before. On the
I'm like a woman when it comes to that shit.
Me and my
I'm not talking about it until you give me this hug.
I was like 28, 29.
Yeah, you hug your son?
Hug him all the time.
Every day. You know what I'm saying?
Every time I see him, first thing hug.
Yo, get the
fuck. And he be like, yo, chill.
I stay kissing my, yo, love you, bud. You know what I mean? I'll make sure he say, love you too, dad. All right, cool.
You know what I'm saying? I wanted kids, man.
Oh, you're a part of the I don't want kids click?
I've always
welcome, brother.
I've you know what's crazy?
We've been talking waiting for you.
I've never wanted
me neither.
My entire life.
Really? I don't want any.
I swore up and down that I did not want any more kids.
Now you want one.
Now you got
I
three.
Think, I think I want.
You're a psycho. You already got two.
Two more.
Two more. So you got three now.
Well, no, my girl got two, so if we gonna make this work, that's three.
Okay, he said if we gonna make this work, if, you mean when?
Oh, no, it's not if, baby, it's not if, baby. We a family.
You got some shot glasses in here?
Let's go.
I got one in the cup over there.
Real talk. Let me tell you something, man, like, I have two kids, you know, and...
How old are your kids?
Well, my son, he just turned 5, and my daughter's 3. So they're like really close.
They're
she
like
turns.
Super close.
She turns 4 now.
Damn, why does it feel like
your kids so long?
Were I thought your kids were older.
Nah.
I thought your girl was Spanish. Y'all not? They not fair?
Nah, I'm done, bro. No more. We good.
You sure?
I'm positive. He's like, yo, snip, bro.
You made the appointment.
I'm positive, bro.
My wife says we have to have one. That was the stipulation.
Just
right?
One?
Yes, yeah, so we have to have one. I'm making the appointment right after the baby comes out. He's
I think they don't, let you until like a certain age and a certain amount of kids.
No, because vasectomies are reversible.
My boy had one, not my boy, a dude I work with. He's probably like 3 years older than me.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, bro, I have to have my second one. I made the appointment while we were in there.
How old is he?
He's 36.
Because they're reversible.
It's easier for us to reverse.
It's easier for us.
Hold on real quick.
Yo, I'll tell you this. If it could prevent... me getting somebody pregnant, I'd get a vasectomy.
Oh, so you just don't.
Oh, I don't want children. I'm good uncle material.
I got
a nephew and a niece.
If I didn't
I
get
love
married,
them
to death,
but I'm not having
not
any kids.
Children.
I want to reel things in just real quick because I got your guys' answer when it comes to a woman.
Yeah, yeah, really.
You.
Well, she bugging.
She's wilding because her baby daddy
she's
there, right?
She's bugging.
You got kids. Be careful.
You know the vibes. But he's a courteous person, so
you got kids, she got kids.
No,
you a baby daddy now. You part of this team.
Oh yeah.
I'm not telling you to be here because this shit's hard. Okay.
This shit is rough.
It's rough. My ass hurts now.
Damn, what should be doing to you? Your ass hurts.
Whoa.
I'll let you see my bank account in a few minutes.
Whoa.
I'm talking about your bank account. I got two.
Right?
And they're on the same age.
He's like, and they're mine.
And they're both mine.
Both mine.
That's crazy.
So
you got one like that's yours.
I can't even
do that. Ain't yours.
You have to judge like, yo, for really, dude? So you're dating a girl. Same thing. What are you doing?
Nah.
Are you understanding?
She's not a courteous.
It depends, like, in the situation. Like,
no, you like her.
Oh, of course.
All
right,
so yeah.
This bitch is inconsiderate.
You're going to have to, like, yo, if it's a valid reason, I'm like, all right, cool. I'm not. Because I'm the type of person.
You're about to pull up.
So what?
You just gonna park and wait?
I'm gonna park and see what the fuck.
I'll catch you later.
Yeah, I'm gonna park
and
see
what the
fuck. But you gonna be mad? Is that a red flag?
It depends.
You can't judge it because you a baby daddy.
Because you don't know.
Because there's been many times that I walked into my baby mom's house, I thought it was gonna be a 2-3 minute thing. That shit ended up being an hour. Like, God. You don't know.
Which is fine. But did you have a prior engagement to that?
He's right. I'm gonna understand right, more.
So with a baby, as a baby daddy, you have obligations, and I won't lie, women have you by the balls.
I believe it.
Right? You may have an agreement. You may have a great agreement with your baby mama. Yo, I give you this much. No court involved. I'll give you this. Oh, it's fine. But if there's some type of animosity between the two. That shit different.
It's just
That's different than me being. That's different than me being unreasonable. Now it's you're bringing in something that doesn't need to be brought into it, and I know that's inevitable because that is just how the human brain works. It doesn't matter if like we don't work. At some point, like I don't want you out here looking fly as fucking shit. Like I don't want that. Like don't be all over Instagram posting pictures of this nigga you on the beach and blah blah blah. bro, no, I'm bad. Like,
damn, I'm wilding out here. I'm over here reposting everything my girl do.
I see.
Yo, that Mariah Carey song, that shit had me dying, bro.
Bro, that shit was good.
That shit had me rolling. That shit was
good. I'm sitting with you. I'm like, bro, that's
bro, a, yeah, you can finally get it.
And I'm like, whoa.
Like, wait,
yo, what? Your face was priceless.
I looked at her like,
he was like,
you heathen?
I looked at her like, who are you? I'm like, who am I with?
A demon.
This is just like, this is general organic shit. Because this shit be happening.
It's true.
Not to me. Because it would never happen to me. Because I don't play that shit.
All right, so let's do the next one. Y'all ready? This is going to get a little dark.
A little dark.
I don't have a stepmom that I know of. All right. How many men did your mom call your uncle?
Fact. Nah, bro. This is for black people specifically. Like,
it's Spanish too.
My mom and my dad were never married, so like it's a little bit of.
So you was an oops baby too?
I don't know.
I think every first kid is a oops baby.
Probably was. I don't know why.
I think the first, if your parents are married and stuff like that, you're not an oops.
Were you married before, when you had your first?
Yeah.
Oh, so you planned it?
Nah.
It was.
Actually, both of mine was a.
He's like, nah. I'm like,
let me
marry.
Let me rephrase. It wasn't. I guess you could say we didn't plan it.
You weren't trying,
we
didn't prevent it. Yeah, you weren't preventing it. If you're like, not trying, then
like, we didn't have this. All right, we wanted this thing, that, whatever.
So I don't want to get too personal, but were you shooting a club of all those years and then like,
not did you all know the years, like, but then it came to the point. Yo, once the time, once you get that taste, you know what it is, bro.
And shit
breaks, and you be like, oh. And you be like, oh.
That, you know, right, that
I'm never wearing this again.
And then you go back.
All right, so real
I'm
quick.
I'm standing on the top of a mountain.
This is amazing.
Yo, it's like that white open. Like,
on a mountaintop.
Like, yo.
All right. Y'all describe that perfectly.
Yeah, that's exactly.
And then you go back
because you're all right. And it's not even hating.
Because you fucked up.
And then you just like,
I'm never putting this thing on again.
Oh, this is boring. Like, and even that.
Is that even we, wet right
do you,
now?
Do you? Can we? Okay, good. And then from there it was a wrap.
Okay. So when you, but you've been with her. You've been with.
I've been my wife for a long time.
You know, yeah, I'm not even comparing myself. Yeah, so, No, go ahead. No, I'm just saying that condom sex is weird. I don't know who does
it's
that.
It's trash. Man. I don't look
up. But what were you gonna ask
I'm
me?
I'm not gonna waste my money on that shit.
No, I'm just saying, like, you being single the last. Shit, you've been single for a minute.
If you're single, I hope you win.
I am.
I don't know how you do it, but I hope you are.
You're missing out. I'll tell you
that. I won't.
Well, I'm working very hard to prevent.
You're gonna have a bunch of different ones. You might as well fill them all.
Because there is different type of wetness.
He's not wrong.
Alright, so put it this way: if I'm having like sex consistently with just like one person.
Yeah, I guess you can.
You can
scrap it.
You know?
No.
No. With one person, like you could occasionally not wear a condom. But if I'm having different partners, I'm strapping up.
What's different partners? Are you talking about like a couple, a few?
You're a great man.
My fucking business.
like if it's a couple, like two couples, two. Like you fuck your.
I don't know nothing about no numbers. No.
You fuck one.
You fuck the main side. You fuck the main one without, and then you fuck the side chick with.
No.
No.
No. No. If it's more with, if it's more than one, I'm strapping up on both.
No, I have no idea what that is.
It's not even my vocabulary.
I'm in love.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I remember sidekicks when you remember T-Mobile.
I'm in love.
I love my baby.
But not for real. My mom's.
I'm in love.
You're disgusting.
My mom introduced me to a gang of different men. It sounds awful. That's it, my mom. But
your mom was a player, bro. Just put it that way. Put it. She's a player,
and she's like, call him uncle, whatever. And I'm like,
this is mommy's special friend.
And like, you get older, you're like, bro. Like,
this nigga ain't never been to Thanksgiving.
I ain't never seen this nigga at a party. I never seen him
at a family reunion.
This nigga's buying me a fucking. go back to school clothes. Like,
oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Why is my uncle buying me so back
uncle,
to school
Uncle clothes? Held it down for the baby daddy.
No, uncle held it down for a minute.
But like, you can't even get mad at
that. Because a lot of the times, because a lot of times mom has an affair with the uncle.
Yeah.
And the uncle ends up being your daddy instead of your real daddy. Like, yo, daddy ain't your daddy.
Uncle so-and-so, does she get you to shoot you back?
Shit, that be on.
So then you got Telemundo. You got uncle this guy. Then you got uncle this guy. That's like, yo, what is all these niggas are smashing your mom.
My mom's.
That's why all. Yo, you remember in middle school, high school, all the black girls be like, yeah, that's my cousin.
Yeah,
that's not really their cousin.
That's why.
That's the same shit. Because their moms be fucking bringing home uncle so and so. That's not your uncle. He's trying to bang you too.
Let's get to the root of that. That's my big brother. How many women were you talking to? And they said, oh, that's my brother.
That's big bro.
No, nigga, that's to do your fucking.
Yeah.
You don't have a brother. No. That's not your brother. Y'all don't know.
I tried to be brothers with mad people. Like, I'm not your brother.
I hang out
here with you, and I'm waiting for my
show. You know how many times I was a brother? You know how many times I was somebody's brother? Yo, yeah, sis.
I'm going to watch this bullshit ass
blow
movie
your
with you.
Back as soon as you give me a
chance. Yeah, I'm going to watch this movie with you. And I'm going to listen to your bullshit. I'm gonna find out everything that nigga's doing wrong.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna do that.
And then you wait for my man. You leaving, dude? My man, you out?
You out, right?
No. Yeah, the worst dirty back is when you know he fucked up and she call you crying.
Facts.
And she's like, yo, he cheated on me. I can't believe it. Damn.
I'll never do that.
Yo, I'm sorry to hear that.
Hey, no, I'm sorry. Where you at?
Hey, where you at?
You follow it up. Like, first you be like, yo, I'm sorry that happened. Where you at?
Like, how you feeling?
You okay? You need me to come over? Need somebody to talk to?
Yeah, we could just talk.
We'll talk. I'm here for
you. I'll bring your favorite food.
Nobody's
Koel.
You know, bitches.
I'm a good listener.
Mm. I'm a great listener.
I'm a great listener.
That's why I got married.
If you need a shoulder to cry on, I got you.
Yeah, that was the best dirty Mac. You were just waiting for him to cheat.
Like, I still use that shit.
He's gonna cheat. I know he's gonna cheat to someone.
I'm single, nigga. I still use that.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I used to wait till summer because I knew niggas was gonna cheat.
Nasty out here.
As soon as Drew hit, I was like,
Oh my god.
As soon as hoodie season's over. Nigga, I used to wait for high school when as soon as sophomore year was over, I was like, oh shit, I'm about to get
gross.
I love him. He gonna love you.
Then 2 months later,
after
she's pregnant
June 21st,
with his baby.
He leaving you.
Oh, gross.
He said, yo.
Y'all about to cut all that out.
My dirty
dude, it's a toxic ass friends
my
podcast.
Dirty
Mac don't
shit.
Be a bitch.
I think my dirty Mac and shit like never worked.
You sure?
I was 50-50 on my dirty Mac.
What was your worst dirty Mac?
I worked in college. When I was in college, it worked. It actually worked very well that one time. The one time I was in college.
Yeah, my dirty Mac worked as I got older.
I watched.
Was it in Montclair?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I watched this girl argue with her man. She lived down the hall from me. I watched her argue with her man. Like every night. Well, in the weekends that he would come to visit, because he wasn't
notes
there.
In his room, just...
He wasn't there, right? But he come to visit over the weekend. And like I always see it, I roomed with the theater kids. Mm-hmm. So like they would throw like little parties and like dances and stuff like that. So we used to always go to the dances and she was a dancer. So she always go to the dances with the theater kids. So I'm like, all right, bet. Boom. I used to see all the time. She's like, yeah, blah, blah. She's flirting or whatever. But she's like, oh, my boyfriend's coming up this weekend. I'm like, that nigga. Oh, the one you be arguing with in the hallway?
He said the one you be arguing.
She's like, we're that loud? I'm like, kinda. Like, we be chilling. We be hearing
something.
Whatever. I'm like, it's not a big deal. And I was like, everybody got their problems. Like, you know what I mean? Like, but, it ain't none of our business. But you're out in the hallway. But it ain't none of our business. Like, it ain't no thing. She's like, oh, yeah. Like, he's just so jealous. Like, mad dicks around. That's why.
Because the nigga's like me.
Yeah. I'm like, wait, he don't go here and all like that? She's like, no.
It's a hallway of dicks. He's doing, right? He's getting all the information.
Yeah. He's at home. He didn't work or some shit like that. I was like, he don't got no job. He don't go to college. Damn, I'm thinking like I ain't the smartest nigga in the world. I'm here.
But he's like, so what do you see in him?
I never.
You're here with the ones that's too dirty.
That's you went too far.
Mm-hmm.
Did you?
Because you're getting personal.
There's a level of
Yes,
you can't
her,
hate on the guy.
You can't ever hate on him, bro.
You can't hate
you
on
allow
the guy.
Her to hate her.
You gotta allow her to trash him at all costs.
Allow her to trash
him. But you can never trash
you,
him.
Because once you trash him, you get
and you, she knows. She's on your game. She's on your game.
I ain't dirty man. I ain't dirty man once in my life. And I was just waiting for him to fuck up.
Why would you want to know that for?
Exactly. And then the one time,
so you show your hand.
Yeah. Then the one time he argued with her one weekend, and then he like stormed out. We all heard like literally.
Niggas stormed out.
They sold out. He like stormed out and he left.
So how did you guys do it? Yo, it's me this time. Rock paper scissors.
I was like, yo, well, my roommates were. My one roommate was gay, so I had to worry about him. And the other one, he was like a punk rocker kid. And she was like a black girl that was a dancer, so he didn't have no chance either. Okay. So I was like,
this is shooing for
you. He's like, I got this.
Oh, so he's like, yo, ain't really.
Yeah,
no, like, it's easy money. I was like,
oh, this is great. Like, this is
mine.
Right? I mean, you know what I mean? I'm like, yo, you good? She's like, nah, he's just bugging out. I'm like,
oh,
you know.
Well, the boyfriend black, too?
Yeah.
Mm.
He just, like, broke out. I was like, yo, you good? She's like, yeah, I'm cool.
I've never stormed
out. I'm about to get something to eat. Like, you know, come downstairs. I'm about to get something to eat. She's like, yeah. I'll come down and get something to eat. I'm like, bet. Then we're going to go up. We're going to watch a movie. And we're going to watch a movie in my room, so-and-so. We used to watch Heroes.
Ooh, Heroes,
we used to have Heroes night in my room.
The first two seasons was lit.
Yo, that whole strike fucked
up. That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. So we used to have Heroes nights in the room. So we used to be like, yo, we about to watch Heroes. So we go back to the room and we had like 6-7 people in there. We watch Heroes.
Yeah, we're definitely showing our age. Yeah,
yo, so you just finger pop
him? So I haven't finger popped anybody in years.
Yo, I haven't finger popped in 2003.
We didn't finger pop. They didn't know that. We came. She came and watched the movie. She let a bunch of other shit off her chest the next day. It took me about
chest.
6 days to close that, and then it was a wrap after that. Yeah, and you know how I fucked it up too? The best part is how I fucked it all up.
So, hold on, did you hit it in the question? Okay, good.
100%.
That's a lot of effort.
No, it wasn't.
6 days is not a lot.
Yo, Dirty Maggin takes no effort because it takes no skin off my back. I'm like, exactly. I don't have to go out of my way to text you every day. I just got to run into you and ask you how you're doing. And when you live down the hall,
I'm gonna see you all the time.
I'm going to see
you. So there's no work involved. Yeah, it's like, you know, you're eventually gonna see her at least once a day.
Yes, I'm gonna see her eventually. Like, we all eat at the same
time. There's not that much.
The dining hall is only open for so many hours for breakfast and for lunch. I'm gonna see you eventually. Like, it doesn't
matter. It's like staying at a resort.
It is. There's nothing you can do about it. And that's why this nigga was so jealous, rightfully so, because he should have been, because there was mad penis.
There's mad dick in that fucking mess hall.
But. I guess she thought she was a little safe because she was in the theater hall. And she thought, you know, niggas in
the theater. All right, theater people are the biggest freaks.
Yo, the
theater people are the biggest freaks. They all fuck each other.
Bro, the theater. I couldn't have been in a better situation, is what I'll say. The theater people are. Yo, you think.
I heard theater chicks.
You think the jocks and all them
are
give it up? Nah, the theater chicks. And the theater chicks are me and my boys first night.
That's why I'm having sex with church girls.
Giving it up. Boom. Them too.
The church girls are the best.
So check out how I fucked
they
it up.
They swear
though.
Up and down.
So after she was like, oh, like we broke up, whatever. I'm like, boom.
But it takes more work with the church girls.
We hang out for a couple weeks.
We'll get to
no big deal, right? So she had a friend, right? She had an ugly friend.
They all do.
Right. So her friend liked my boy, my best friend, right? So I was texting him. And I'm like, yo, like.
I need you to take this.
I'm like, yo, this girl. And I didn't even need him, like, at that point. We were just talking shit. Like, I'm like, yo, this girl needs. He's like, yo, so-and-so that's always with her? Because he had seen her a couple times. I'm like, yeah. He's like, yo, I don't know about all that. I go to text him back. I'm like, yo, yeah, she look a little crazy, but it's not a big deal. I sent the text to her, and I'm like, boy.
Yo, you are sick. You are sick, nigga.
Yo, tell me why I tried to clean it up. Like, yo, like I said that by accident, but like I was just telling him that to lighten him up.
Yeah, what
like,
is the craziest text that I've ever sent?
Bro, but it was back then when I had the.
Mine was recent.
Montclair State gave you a phone. It was like a flip phone. It was an old flip phone.
They gave you a phone?
Yeah, they gave you a phone for campus because it was easy for you to get your campus alerts and shit like that. And this was in 2007. Like, and they give you like your campus alerts on your phone. It was separate from your personal phone, but a lot of kids used it as their actual cell phone, so their parents didn't have to pay, or you didn't have to pay for
that's
a phone.
Fine. They ain't doing that shit
sense.
No more, though.
Yeah, nah, they ain't doing it no more. But they never cut it off. As long as you were enrolled, you had your phone. Mm. It's no big deal. But, like, I had two phones. So I wasn't paying attention. I just wasn't paying attention. Because he would hit me sometimes on my school phone, but most of the time it was on my phone. But just this time specifically, he happened to hit me on my school phone. And I never text anything on my school phone unless I was texting her or my roommates or something else. Mm. And I sent that shit on my school phone. I wasn't fucking paying attention.
Were you, so you weren't able to clean it up?
Oh, no. She was gone
and
right after.
Get back to Ralph's thing with she the church right girls, after. They're always horny, so it's too easy.
Not all the time.
Not all the time, but most
not all the time. Most of the time,
they're not. Right, girl at Bible study.
I'm gonna tell you this right now, and if they say they're not, that means that they're getting dicked down. Right?
That's toxic.
It is.
Nah, but he's right though. I mean, that's what we're here for tonight, tough. Right?
Because I'll be honest with you, like I've dealt with women that are in deep. I'm talking about deep in religion. Where I was the one saying no. And she was grabbing like, excuse me, miss.
Never said no.
I said no. I'm like, excuse me, miss, I have work tomorrow morning and
I can imagine, yo, my rage is getting manhandled by this bitch.
No.
I said no.
Yo, he out here like, no. Like, nah, for real. I said no. Like, yo, give me, and she just out here like, just grabbing your dick.
Your summer girl is taller than you?
Yes. She's her name is Ashley.
Damn, bro. You put her down. So we're beeping her name. Right?
And you notice how he said that. You had to look up, right?
Yeah. Her name is Ashley. Yeah, I remember how big she was.
I want to say she was like at least a good inch or two taller than me.
That's not bad.
And it wasn't too bad. But then there was one time when I went to go to her crib and she stood out on the front steps. And then her heel was in the back of the step.
Crazy.
And then her foot was over the step. And there was a lot of foot left. Like that much. So I'm like, and then I looked at my feet.
I looked at her.
Hey! Yo, you was out here getting...
Yo, you was out here getting it in
with Lisa Leslie?
And,
Hey!
I spilled White Claw on me, everybody, who is not watching YouTube.
Sorry for you spilling white claws.
I'm nervous.
You got nothing to do with me. If that's what it is, you're moving real jittery right now.
Either way, her foot was over the step way too much. So I saw her foot, I saw my foot.
And then you cut it off.
And I was like, yeah, you're way bigger than me.
You're way too
and that's
bigger.
It. You cut it off.
And I cut her off.
Yeah. Right there.
You cut her off right there.
She was.
I've never done that before.
She was good.
What, just
was
like, just.
Mm-hmm. I slept with a girl that was taller than me. I'm like 5'10", almost 5'11", and she was like 6'2".
She was even that tall. My
motto was, yo, I like climbing trees. I climbed trees as a kid.
I hooked up with a girl that was taller than me.
Damn.
How does that work? Because you're tall, bro.
I'm 6'2".
Damn, bro.
I said damn.
She was like 6'3", 6'4". She's a volleyball player.
That's why.
Yeah, she was huge.
Oh, she's the one that spikes it.
Wait, she's huge.
Her hands are gigantic.
You also, when she grabbed your dick, you felt like, oh shit, don't touch it.
I'm good.
I'm just asking. Because I thought it would touch my shoulder. Hey,
good.
Chill.
I'm good. But.
Yeah. Like, why he did it? Like, nah, bro, yeah, I'm good.
I'm good. He had Andre the Giant grabbing his dick.
I'm just saying. I look at women's hands all the time. Make sure.
You gotta relax.
Because I've had one grandma, I'm like, oh, wait, I'll do it myself. Move.
Nah, I'm good. We're good. I'm okay.
He said, no, stop. She tried to grab two hands. I'm like, what you doing?
Her hands were fine.
She tried to do one of these?
Okay. She had big hands, though. She did have big hands.
Yeah. She's trying to do the salt, the
pepper grinder. Pepper grinder.
Hey, yo.
I grabbed the other hand so fast. Hey,
you don't need that.
You remember that? You're doing just fine.
Just like this.
Oh, man.
You want this to work?
Hey, by the way, these are all jokes, everybody. I'm joking.
No, you're not joking.
He's
so serious.
I'm not joking.
Pepper grinder,
I'm not joking.
Yeah, we'll call it.
This looks crazy, man.
Can you stop doing it?
We'll call it BG before girlfriend.
Can you stop doing it, like, right next
pre-girlfriend, pre-relationship.
I have a past. It wasn't her.
We all do.
That's what I said, pre-girlfriend. Before your girlfriend came into the picture.
Nah,
no,
I'm
good.
Big no-no.
I'm
okay.
The fucking black pepper grinder.
What's wrong with she?
You better do that to me.
It wasn't that 6'7".
Don't show up. No, why are you here?
Why did I have... How tall is she?
Why are you here?
It's a certain height average.
Yeah.
6'7" to do this to you?
a lot of fucking six, seven, man.
Six, seven is real.
Yo, has a girl ever done anything to you, like, in bed, like, that makes you feel like less of a man, like, emasculated?
No. This.
Thank God.
The,
no, apparently that's a trigger for this guy.
Yo, it reminds me of this that one episode with
girl trying to take my drawers off. That was emasculating. Oh,
with the
the girl at the bar, right?
No, not the girl at the bar. The one with the
bar. No,
was Steve that jerked over at the bar?
Nah, the one with him in middle school, his girl.
Oh yeah,
with the varsity dress. Yo,
this is exactly what
I was. Remember, I went to McManus. I didn't go to Seoul.
Oh, I'll tell you off air.
So, but here, I have an idea now that you said
that. That's funny.
I think I have an idea.
That was one. That was hilarious.
Yo, that shit had me rolling on the way to work, man. My man was just like, yo, I had to wear a varsity jacket, too. And then he said I had to wear his t-shirt.
He had to tuck it in.
In my head, I'm thinking, he probably asked, yo, can I borrow your scrunchie? So you know how they used to tie it in a knot?
A little thing for the hair knot.
They put it in a knot. But I never...
Wait. Steve wore a girl's varsity jacket.
No, God.
Oh.
She played softball.
Yeah, she was way bigger. She was way bigger.
You know, wait, I know exactly who that is.
That had me rolling.
She's got a family now, too. Congrats to her.
Dude, congrats to her.
I'm dying, bro. I never laughed so hard on the way to work. My stomach was hurting, man.
But I feel like any girl can overpower God. Just a little ass man.
My man said he had to go to the game and sit in the bleachers.
Yeah. Where he's like cheering for you. Sitting by himself.
Go, babe, go.
Sitting there by himself.
That's my bae.
That's my bae, man.
He wore her Letterman's jacket every Friday.
Shit.
He gets dominated right now.
And it was too big for him.
Why do you think he didn't show up for the pod?
That's why he rolled the sleeves up. Just sit on the camera.
Soon as she heard one of them episodes, he disappeared off this motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Oh man,
you gotta go home and make it clear, man, before you pop up on one of these, because things get a little crazy. You know
sure
what I mean?
Does.
You gotta let one of them disclaimers go a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Because things get a little nuts. Mm-hmm. You never know.
So to wrap up 14.
40 minutes in.
Ready to wrap 14 up, ready? Last one.
Jesus Christ.
10 minutes left.
Everyone relax.
Can you date a woman who doesn't know how to cook? Or be in a relationship with a woman who doesn't cook? And if you're in a relationship now, be open, fellas.
She can't cook.
And she can't cook. How do you guys deal with it?
Okay. I answered this question already.
What if she cooks certain things?
What's
her
thing?
Well.
Breakfast?
Yeah, no. The question is if she don't cook at all.
No.
Cook.
Like
you go home and there's like, baby, what you want to eat? And you can just ask for whatever you want and she go make it.
And she knows how to make it.
Oh, I don't know anything about that. I'm sorry.
Okay, cool. So,
I don't even ask
because, you know, whatever she cook, my wife could cook. So whatever.
Okay, so you're in good hands.
So I'm good.
I'm in good hands.
So let me clear this thing.
Thank God.
Let me clear myself up here. My wife can cook certain things.
Okay. But that's like me though. Like I cook certain things.
There are certain things that she just won't do. Like she doesn't. She just doesn't.
But the general consensus is that she can cook.
The general consensus is that we will not go hungry.
Okay. And okay, but no. So
the question
poses if she can't cook at all.
That's like
the food that she cook, is it good?
It's delicious.
Oh, okay. Say less. Okay. So
the things
that
she can cook.
So yeah, don't apply
that.
Flavorful.
All right, cool. So let's talk to the single person in the room.
Because she actually uses more seasoning than I do, which I've never seen in my life.
Holy shit!
I watched this girl season something before she.
Really?
I was like. Hey, yo, I don't think
can you not do that again? That was President Trump video.
Oh, that's nuts.
Baby, that's a lot of salt. I'm glad.
Yeah, you gotta relax.
We got bad hearts.
My people get high cholesterol, baby.
Yeah, this is real. You gotta chill.
Hold that elbow.
But her brother can cook really good. Like, he can cook anything really well. So she tries to, emulate what he does.
Okay.
But she don't do meat. Like, she doesn't do, like, red meat and stuff So, like, that stuff, she don't do.
Okay.
But, we love red meat.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, bro, I just got a smoker.
Oh, yeah, we spoke about that.
God,
yeah,
bro.
Her brother got one, too. So he be killing it. So when he's like, yo, we having dinner? Yo.
I'm getting one. I'm about to get a smoker.
Yo, I'm there, buddy. Mm-hmm. He made me this salmon that was, like, a pound salmon.
Like,
I didn't even know they made salmon that big.
Yeah.
This shit was huge. I'm like, bro, how am I supposed to eat this? That's what I'm saying. I'm like, bro, how the hell am I supposed to eat this
fuck that shit. No, you got it. So let's ask Ralph, the single man. You said you.
I answered the question.
You answered the question. I posted it on.
But Instagram. We'll speak on it right please now. Do.
So he said yes.
I know how to cook, so okay. I'm fine in that department because I don't give a fuck if a girl can cook or not. Because either I'm teaching her or I'll just cook for myself. I can give no fucks.
Real quick to play devil.
But I do think that regardless if it's a man or woman, we should all know how to do basic life skills.
Contribute.
Like it's a basic life skill. Everybody should know how to do it. But to get to the question though,
you never do anything by yourself. Ever, bro. I can go and I can call my wife right now and I'll leave from here and I'll drive home and I could assume that she's eaten already, which is probably true. Mm-hmm. And I'll just stop at like Wendy's or something just to get myself to eat real quick.
Ooh, that's an argument, like, bro.
You just got yourself.
We don't live together,
man. You ate like I thought.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Like, so even when you're cooking, like, and you're cooking just for yourself because, like, she don't cook or whatever.
No. Okay, so I don't mean about. So when I meant cooking by myself, I didn't mean cooking just for me.
Though. I know you don't mean like going
getting
to the
it done,
and, like,
getting it done on my own. Like, if you're gonna do something, do it yourself. Fucking like that's my mentality.
To play devil's advocate on that, and like if
I'm gonna get him a shirt that says to play devil's advocate, and I want to make like a drinking game. Y'all gonna get a drinking game? Like how many times he says to take a shot every time?
What do you have me here for?
He loves saying devil. That's his thing.
But it to me personally, it'll get to a certain point where you're cooking all the time. And she's going to be like, well, this motherfucker cooking, so why do I have to do more? I'm going to go do what I got to do. Pilates.
We split the responsibilities. Bro.
So that's a difficult question because I enjoy cooking.
Yeah, so for someone that enjoys cooking.
Like, it's therapeutic for me.
Yeah.
So that's like, if I'm having a stress fucking day, come home, I'm about to make some shit, and by the time I'm done and I eat it, nigga. Shit.
That's pretty good, actually.
I'm good. Like, it's therapeutic for me. I like cooking.
Me and my wife both hate cooking. So this is where we have to split the responsibility. So if I know we're making, like, some chicken or something, I got to throw on the grill. I'll do that. And she'll just take care of everything else. So she'll cut the potatoes. If we have potatoes, she'll cut the potatoes up, season them joints. Mm. We have vegetables, she'll cut them up, season them, whatever.
But y'all cook together, right? That.
Well, we have to because neither one of us like cooking. Mm. So if you leave it up to us, I got the pizzeria on speed dial.
I guess to be serious about us, me finally being serious, my past relationship, I will never help cook ever.
Really?
Now, I'm in there like...
Well, you just didn't enjoy...
I'm in there like, babe, what you need?
Yeah, you just...
I'm the sous chef, nigga.
When you enjoy being around a person like that, it changes
you. It changes
you.
You do different things.
Like, babe, you need this?
Because I hate it, and she hates it. But if we're both doing it, we're good. Word.
Yeah.
But I despise... Bro, if I came home every day and I didn't have to do it, if I didn't have to eat for sustenance, I'd be like, guess what am I eating tonight?
I think... For when COVID started, you know what I mean, and you know everything was going crazy and all that stuff like that, that's when I actually started, like, we started to grill every weekend, me and my family. We're grilling, then I started looking at different type of stuff, and that's when I was like, yo, I want to do a brisket. You know what I mean? I want to try a brisket.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm like, yo, babe, I'm going to get a brisket. I want to try it. I want to see how it is, da-da-da-da. And then I found out, I need to buy a smoker. That kind of like for you with your, you know, doing
literally,
this process.
Same thing.
And then it's like, all right. And then now it becomes something, but now it's more like, all right, now I done it, and I'm seeing the outcome of it. Like,
I saw that ring. I saw that ring.
That smoke ring was pretty, bro.
I saw it.
But you know,
it's
even like, the feedback that I was getting, like, yo, this is, but the process to get it done too at the same time. So now, but then my wife too, at the same time, she was helping. Like, I'm focused on the meat, all that stuff. You know what I mean? But she's doing the whole, salad, all the other stuff and all that
stuff. So it's not falling on him.
It's like a group effort.
If you want anything to survive outside of what you're doing, unless your wife doesn't work, you're gonna have to split it.
Unless there's a time,
the only time that I cook fully is if my wife is working and I've been home all day and I'm not doing shit.
What?
That's the only time. Other than that, we both are done at work at the same time. You have to split it. That's the only way to make it work. Yeah. Nobody wants to do it themselves every single
I'll tell you, like me personally, I don't cook as well as my girl does, right? But I told her we have a deal. We have an agreement. You cook, I clean.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's always
cooking, I'm cleaning.
If you grew up, that was
Like my thing is like she puts a plate to the side, I'm busting them suds. Yeah. Babe, what you need? You need me to get something for the fridge? Yeah. That's part of maturity, I guess you could say.
Good dishwasher, I don't even fuck about none of that.
I gotta get my pockets right.
Baby steps, bro.
Any closing notes on this toxic?
Y'all split that shit, man, and stop playing games, cause niggas be playing. That's the problem. Niggas be playing.
Be
niggas,
smart.
Niggas have a girl who would do all that shit for you. You think she gonna do that shit forever?
Yeah, and it's like y'all take her for granted.
It's not one sided.
You know what I mean? It's she's not gonna do it all the time. You gonna come? Then she gonna, you gonna have Doritos and a sandwich on your plate.
It's not a 50-50 partnership. It's a 100-100 partnership. 50% you're implying that you're half assing.
My advice to all the single men and people who are in newly relationships: it's half and half, yo.
Be careful, cause it's nasty.
It's half and half, man. It's half and half.
It's gross.
It's nasty, so I'll tell you that right now.
I forgot how it is. I don't want to remember.
It's nasty.
I don't want to remember.
You do not want to be out here.
I try everything in my power to make sure my wife is happy.
I couldn't wait to retire. I do. I'm good.
Bro, we be out chilling, you know, say we had an engagement or whatever, and then, you know, I'm on one side of the room and she's on the other side of the room, and I, you know, we make that eye contact, you know, she say, you know, she give me the head nod, everything cool, or she give me the stare.
Ah,
you know what I mean?
So, oh, we gotta go.
Stand.
We about to leave, right?
And it's just like
somebody been laughing at your jokes.
And then I'm just like,
too funny, nigga.
Let me retrace my steps,
bro.
I went here.
I've been.
You know what I mean? Oh, okay.
I've been the too funny nigga.
Bro.
I gotta relax.
You know me already, so.
Well, I almost punched my wife in the face at that barbecue. She was. Yeah, real fucking.
We gonna stop talking about that,
bro. Bro, I can't, bro. She's talking about that shit, bro. I'm really like, this nigga, man.
Oh my god, he's so interested. No, the fuck, he's not. Bitch, he's not interesting at all. What the fuck you talking about?
Why are you so interested?
Why don't you be with him then?
Yeah, like, what you mean? He's wearing long sleeves in the fucking summer. What the fuck?
Oh, I know exactly who that is.
He's not doing this shit, bro. I'm good, man. Shit.
He just made the year change.
This nigga's not interested.
On that note, let's thank Wes for coming through.
Yo,
man.
Thanks for having me, man. I had a good time, man. You guys are great. Yo, I want to say one thing though. Like, yo, what you guys are doing, bro, I love it. I appreciate it. You guys are doing good things, bro. Keep rocking, man. Keep flowing.
Thank you for supporting, man. No, we appreciate it.
Somebody
man.
Keeps us on the structure path.
Word.
That's why Ralph is back to keep us back, keep us on our toes. Well,
at least you know what episode you're listening to. Man, thank you for coming.
No, man. Thanks for
nice to meet
me,
you
bro.
Too, man.
No, nice to meet you too, bro.
Peace, bitches.
Nice. We out.
Yeah. They hate to see a young nigga living from the slums. When it's all said and done, I'm forgiven. Any minute you can step into the wrong city limits. I'm just finishing another loud pack, plenty Guinness like. All of my fans in attendance, I'm a menace. Got them serving up the ace like it's tennis in the building. I've been putting on for the tenants. Tell a pair of different women try and brandish my image like. You get exposed. I see these new niggas using my flows. None of my jewelry, cubics, or comb. My shorty live like a nudist, I know.